Good morning students, welcome back to Sharda Maths channel. Now this is the continuation video of the Eamcet coaching classes mastery complex numbers video number 3. And the students who will follow these videos will definitely attempt so many questions in the coming Eamcet examination. So all of you watch the video and make the notes and practice all the models of these questions. Okay, let us start the class. The first one, if modulus of z minus 4 by z is equals to 2, then what is the maximum value of the mod z? Okay, this expression is given, we want the maximum value of the mod z. So first I take the given condition here. Given condition is mod z minus 4 by z is equals to 2 and mod z is equal to, to find the maximum value of this expression, first I am taking this value mod z is equal to, so this is nothing but mod z minus 4 by z plus 4 by z, that is simply I apply the value minus 4 by z and plus 4 by z to this value like that. And what is the formula for mod z1 plus z2? Mod z1 plus z2 is less than or equals to mod z1 plus mod z2. Okay, that is mod z is less than or equals to. So this is in the form of the mod z1 plus z2. That is nothing but less than or equal to mod z1 plus mod z2. That is, first I take that this total value is equal to z1 and this is equal to z2. That is less than or equals to mod z minus 4 by z plus modulus of 4 by z. Okay, just I apply the formula mod z1 plus z2 is equals to, is less than or equals to mod z1 plus mod z2, which implies mod z is less than or equals to, this already given this value is equal to 2 here, 2 plus 4 by z. Okay, now doing the LCM, mod z is less than or equals to 2 into mod z plus 4 by mod z. Taking the cross product, mod z square minus 2 into mod z is less than or equals to 4. Now adding the plus 1 on both sides, mod z square minus 2 into mod z plus 1 is less than or equals to 5. And this total value is nothing but mod z minus 1 whole square, that is less than or equals to 5, which implies mod z minus 1 is less than or equals to root 5. So the value of the mod z is less than or equal to root 5 plus 1. That is, the value of the mod z is less than root 5 plus 1 or equals to root 5 plus 1. Means this is the maximum value of the mod z. That's all. Okay, this value is either equals to root 5 plus 1 or less than or equals to root 5 plus 1. So this is nothing but the maximum value of the given expression. That's all. See the next problem. So two conditions are given here. The first condition is mod z1 minus 1 is less than 2 and the second condition is mod z2 minus 2 less than 1. So what is the given question? What is the value of the mod z1 plus mod z2? We have to find this value. So I am taking that it's, so we have to find this one. Is it less than or some values are greater than this value? So first I take that this equals to, just I am converting this value as the given values, that is mod z1 minus 1 plus z2 minus 2 plus 3. Okay, that is without changing this value, just I apply the numbers minus 1 minus 2 plus 3 like that. Since we have the values of mod z1 minus 1 and mod z2 minus 2. And what is the formula for the mod z1 plus z2 plus z3? This is less than or equals to mod z1 plus mod z2 plus mod z3. Okay, this is also the formula, less than or equals to. So this is less than or equals to, I take the first complex number as the z1 minus 1, mod z1 minus 1, plus second complex number as mod z2 minus 2 plus mod 3. Okay, less than or equal to mod z1 plus mod z2 plus mod z3. But already here we have that this value is less than 2. Less than 2 plus this is less than 1. Less than 1 plus 3. That is, this entire value is less than 6. So the answer is mod z1 plus z2 less than 6. And that is the last option. Okay. Now see the next problem. The principal amplitude of the 2 minus I into 1 minus 2 I whole square is in the interval. Okay, this value is given. We have to find the principal amplitude. So first I take that this is the complex number z. Z is equal to given as here 2 minus I into 1 minus 2 I whole square. So taking the expansion, so this is 2 minus I into 1 plus 4 I square. Plus 4 I square is equal to minus 4 minus 4 I. Okay, is equals to 2 minus I into minus 3 minus 4 I. Okay, and this is equals to minus 6 plus 3 I minus 8i plus 4i square, but I square is equals to minus 1. This is minus 6 minus 5i minus 4 equals to minus 10 minus 5i. That is, the complex number is here. We get the complex number as minus 10 comma minus 5. Both are negative, means this is in the third quadrant. So what is the range of the angles of the third quadrant? Minus pi to minus pi pi root. Okay. Therefore, theta belongs to minus pi to minus pi pi 2. Both are negative. Minus 6 minus 5 means third quadrant. The range of the angle of the third quadrant is minus pi to minus pi by 2, and that is equals to third option. Okay. Okay, see the next one. If pi by 3 and pi by 4 are the arguments of the z1 and z2 bar, then what is the value of the r z1 into z2? Okay, so given that here pi by 3 and pi by 4 are the arguments of the z1 z2 bar, that is, given that r z1 is equal to pi by 3 and r z2 bar is equals to pi by 4. R z2 bar is equals to pi by 4 means r z2 is equal to minus pi by 4. Okay, just bar r z bar is equal to theta means r z is equal to minus theta by applying that formula. What is the given question? We want the value of the r z1 into z2, but r z1 into z2 is equal to formula r z1 plus r z2. But what is r z1 value? Pi by 3. R z2 value minus pi by 4. Doing the LCM, 4 pi minus 3 pi by 12 is equals to pi by 12. That's all. That is the answer, which is the second option. Okay. Now the next one. The mod amplitude form of the 1 plus cos theta plus I sin theta. Okay. What is the formula for the mod amplitude form of the complex number? R into cos theta plus I sin theta. This is the formula for the mod amplitude form. What is given here? Z is equal to 1 plus cos theta plus I sin theta. Means here we have to convert this expression in this form. This is the mod amplitude form. So first, simply by applying the trigonometric formulas here, directly will get the answer. What is the formula for the 1 plus cos theta? 2 cos square theta by 2. And what is the formula for the sin theta? 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2. Okay, just applying the two formulas here to this one. Now taking the common terms common, what are common here? 2 cos theta by 2 is the common term. So 2 cos theta by 2 into cos theta by 2 plus I sin theta by 2. That's all. This is clearly, this converted in the form of the r into cos theta plus I sin theta. So this is equals to 2 into cos theta. What is the formula for the cos theta by 2 plus I sin theta by 2? Sis theta by 2. And that is nothing but the second option. Okay, that's all. Okay, so the next problem, log of log a. What is this value? So first I am writing the given question here, log of log a, and we have one formula for one term, e power I theta is equal to cos theta plus I sin theta. The most important formula for the objective, the formula for e power I theta is equal to cos theta plus I sin theta. So what is the formula for the e power I pi by 2 cos pi by 2 plus I sin pi by 2? And already we know that cos pi by 2 is equal to 0, sin pi by 2 is equals to 1. So this becomes only 1. 0 plus I into 1 is equals to 1. So here in place of this I substitutes the value e power I pi by 2. Okay. I is nothing but e power I pi by 2. So this is log of, writing the power as the quotient, that is I pi by 2 into log e. And what is log e? This is equals to 1. Log e is equals to 1 means this becomes log I pi by 2. Again, this is in the form of the log a plus log b, that is log I plus log I pi by 2. Log a plus log b. Again, log I is equals to, in place of I, again I substituting that e power I pi by 2. So the value of the I is equals to e power I pi by 2. Okay. E power I pi by 2 plus log pi by 2. Writing the power as the quotient. So this becomes I pi by 2 into log e plus log pi by 2, but log e is equals to 1 here, so this becomes I pi by 2 plus log pi by 2. That's all, and that is the third option. Okay, now see the next problem. Tan of I into log of a minus ib by a plus ib. So this is the given question. So first I am taking the given question here, a power tan of I log a minus ib by a plus ib, and this is equals to, first I take the rationalization to this one, tan of I log a minus ib by a plus ib into a minus ib by a minus ib, and this is equals to tan of I log a minus ib into a minus ib is equal to a minus ib whole square, and the denominator is equal to a square minus I square b square, a plus b into a minus b, that becomes a square plus b square. Now taking the numerator expansion, tan of I log, this is a square plus I square b square is equal to minus b square minus I of 2ab by a square plus b square. Now separating the denominator to both the real and imaginary parts here, tan of I log, first value a square minus b square by a square plus b square plus I into minus 2ab by a square plus b square. Now I take that the first value is equals to cos theta, second value is equal to sin theta. So this is tan of I log, so cos theta plus I sin theta, cos theta plus I sin theta is equal to formula e power I theta. Okay, just I take that this cos theta, this sin theta, cos theta plus I sin theta is equals to e power I theta. So this is tan of I into I theta into log e. Okay, log e, and here log e becomes 1, I square is equal to minus 1. So this is tan of minus theta, and that is minus tan theta equals to minus. So what is tan theta value? Sin theta by cos theta, that is minus 2ab by a square minus b square. Okay, sin theta by cos theta, denominators are cancelled. So this becomes 2ab by a square minus b square, and which is equals to second option. Okay, see the next problem. Log of 1 plus I root 3 by 1 minus I root 3 is equals to log of, first in the first step I apply the value 2 to the both numerator and denominator like that. So this is 2 of 1 by 2 plus I root 3 by 2 by 2 of 1 by 2 minus I root 3 by 2, cut the number 2, and this is equals to cos of pi by 3 plus I sin pi by 3 whole pi, this is cos of pi by 3 minus I sin pi by 3. Okay, and this is log of cos pi by 3 plus I sin pi by 3 is equals to e power I pi by 3, cos pi by 3 minus I sin pi by 3 is equals to e power minus I pi by 3 is equals to log of, so e power I pi by 3 by e power minus I pi by 3 is equals to e power I pi by 3 plus I pi by 3. Okay, now this is equals to log e power I into 2 pi by 3, that is I into 2 pi by 3 into log e, but log e is equal to 1, therefore the answer is equals to I into 2 pi by 3, and that is the second option. That's all, and I will continue the remaining sums in the next video.